main event time. The Alpha Championship is on the line. I mean, it's not often you see a championship match on the main show. Superplexes in the symphony. Oh my god. Super kick! Silva's got the ropes. No! What? You gotta be kidding me. Not this way. We have a new Alpha Champion. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to episode 2 of OWA Fallout. I, of course, am Braylon Summers here. Yes, I am here. It's been a long day at the office. I've been working with some talent backstage before the show. I'm extremely tired, but I am here for all of you. And man, what a night we had at episode 1. I mean, a new Alpha Champion. Speak of the devil, here he comes. Our new Alpha Champion, Donny Octave, is coming out here now. And you can say he won the championship under very controversial standings. I mean, you saw in the package we had at the beginning of the program. He, of course, delivered that impactful super kick to now former champion, Brickwall Alex Silva. But when Silva grabbed the ropes, the referee downright ignored it. Costed him the championship. As you can see, Mr. Octave is not dressed to compete. He's got his new Octave Club t-shirt and his pretty little blue jeans on, and he's coming out here all cocky. So I guess he's gonna have some words for us here. The fact is, he put on one hell of a match on episode 1. And I just don't like his attitude. I don't like his methods for winning. But looks like the champ is calling for a mic. So let's hear what he's got to say.
Last week, I finally did it. I did what I said I was going to do for the past months. Last week, I finally became OWA Alpha Champion. How long did I say
this guy?
Honestly, how long? How long did I say that the only reason Alex Silva was defeating me on every occasion was because of those stupid, extreme stipulations? And come on, hardcore rules matches, tables matches, it's ridiculous. It's utterly ridiculous.
You're ridiculous,
buddy. Fact is, the man, he had help from those stipulations. It guaranteed him victory on every single occasion. All the times. But I knew that the very second I could get him in a normal match, that gold would be all mine. And once again, I called. I told each and every single one of you this would happen. Nobody believed me. Well, what do you have to say now? An apology, perhaps? I want an apology from you people for calling me a liar. Come on! Over here! Come on!
Man, I can barely hear myself think over these boos.
Fine. I was planning on taking my life anyway. And you know why I wasted my time coming out here for all of you bitches.
I think this is an appropriate time to say it, but thank God somebody comes out here to shut Donny Octave up. And it is, of course, the former Alpha Champion, Brickwall Alex Silva. Now you've got to guess, this man is not at all pleased with the outcome of his match on episode 1. I mean, the man put on one hell of a show. We saw the Superplex Symphony in full swing. The man bled unbelievably. I mean, I'm surprised the ring wasn't doused in the man's own blood. But nonetheless, unfortunately, he did come up short and lose the Alpha Championship under very controversial reasons, and the man's walking down here with a purpose. I mean, I've never seen the man walk down here so intense as he is right now. And now you see Donny Octave's gotten out of the ring. Clearly, he's not man enough to face Silva face to face. But it looks like Silva's calling for a mic too, so let's see what Brickwall's gonna say.
You know, this would be the part of the story where the former champion comes out, congratulates the new champion, and wishes the best of his reign. Only problem is, the new champion is a slithering little snake who can't get the job done without a screw job, and face it, Donny, it's not like anybody saw how the match ended last week. Everybody saw me grab the rope, and the referee ignored it and counted to 3 anyway. I know you had some sort of trick up your sleeve, and because of that, you unfairly captured my championship. So, I'm gonna put it to you bluntly, Donny Octave. I want my rematch right here tonight.
Oh, wow! Alex Silva laying it out how it is.
Really? Really? You're gonna pull that crap? You are seriously going to demand a rematch? Tonight?
Really?
I don't think you understand how this works, dear Alex. This isn't like some companies where you get a guaranteed rematch if you lose the belt, okay? So, as far as your rematch goes, consider it denied.
Oh, come on, Donny! Be a man! What's going on? What's going on with our... What the...
Hold on a second, Donny Octave. I don't think you understand how this works. You see, you may have won the championship last week with help from that referee that you paid off, and I've dealt with him properly. But just because you're now Alpha Champion doesn't mean that you run the show. This is my show, and you will answer to me. Now with that said, you do make a point. You have to earn a rematch, Alex Silva, and I will give you that chance tonight. As you go one-on-one with a mystery opponent in the main event. If you win, then at our first CPV, OWA Adrenaline, you will get your rematch against Donny Octave for the OWA Alpha Championship. Good luck, Alex.
Oh my... Wow. Okay, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. I don't know what happened there with our feed, but I'm getting word now. The man who interrupted The opening segment was, in fact, the anonymous OWA general manager, and he made a match. Brickwall Alex Silva versus a mystery opponent in a number one contenders match for the Alpha Championship at our first CPV OWA Adrenaline. Wow! What an announcement. Just what an announcement. I don't even know who this man is, but I like him. But moving on, we're kicking off the show with a Rising Star Showcase for the tournament. Now, this was not mentioned on episode 1, but the Rising Star Showcase matches that you will see over the next few weeks, including the one last week with Elijah Roseberry and Brad B. Bad, are to determine the last four spots in the bracket. Four men have already been decided at house shows, and of course we will reveal them at a later time. So these four matches that will of course appear over the next couple weeks leading up to Adrenaline are to decide the last four men in the bracket. And of course already in the ring right now is Joey Raiden, the son of OWA legend Noah Raiden. And coming out to the ring now, you probably just saw the nameplate, is Juice Mandela. This guy is very interesting. I like the afro. I can honestly say that. I'm digging the fro, man. That's a nice fro. He's coming out, he looks like he's got the fans mesmerized with these weird movements and antics. A little more background on Joey Raiden, because I just do not know much about Juice here. Joey Raiden, of course, the son of one of the most decorated men in OWA, Noah Raiden. Got training from the best in Japan, as you can probably tell from, like I said, the fact that he has a freaking black belt and the Japanese ninja-styled logos on his tights there. And he's coming out here to make a name for himself and be a part of the Rising Star Championship tournament that will happen sometime after OWA Adrenaline. But anyway, back into the match here, we see Raiden has Juice backed up into the corner here, and a clean break. Clearly these two are fan favorites, they have respect for one another. And this ought to be interesting, as they tie up again, and Juice has him in a side headlock and takes him down. That's a funny name, Juice Mandela. Very interesting name, Juice. Juice. Can't say I've heard a name like that before. But nonetheless, Juice Mandela now having Raiden with that arm. Looks like he might have been trying to pop it out. And now Raiden backing up into the ropes again. Man, Joey Raiden is such a fantastic young kid, and he's just so technically skilled. Look at this, whipping Juice out, and he falls down to the floor. And now they're right out here in front of me, ladies and gentlemen, as the referee's count begins. And now Raiden just snapmaring him down with the elbows right to the face. Oh man, that's rough. That's really rough. Look at this. These two just slugging it out. And Juice looks to be taking it back into the ring. Sliding back in. Sliding in over top of Joey Raiden. And now Raiden slipping out of that. And now Juice backing Raiden into the corner. Ooh! That was so fast I could barely even call it in time, ladies and gentlemen. This kid, Juice Mandela, is super quick from what I can tell right here. And what's he doing? Just snap suplex on the outside. Man, there might be pounding out there, ladies and gentlemen, but it is... Oh! It is not that thick. And Joey Raiden hit that Meteora move right there on the outside and is cranking on the neck of Juice Mandela. As the referee's count is to 5 now, both men must try to get back in the ring. Juice getting up.
Raiden's distracted, and it turns around to bite him as Juice goes after the leg with that shin breaker. And now, oh wait, Raiden with a European uppercut. And now Juice catches him, lifts him up, and ooh, big slam to Joey Raiden. Oh, Raiden kicks Juice off. Now, I'm not exactly sure what Joey Raiden's finishing move is. This is the first time I'm actually seeing Joey in action. But Juice, I've heard, is very skilled with his knees. Of course, he has these just wild barrages of knee-type moves. He uses face breakers and just knee strikes. He's just very skilled with those knees. So if I were Joey Raiden, I would go after the legs of Juice. Look at that foot stomp right there, using his legs, using those powerful legs to work on Joey Raiden, and now working over the arm. I'm gonna guess maybe Raiden's finisher has something to do with that arm, so Juice may be working it over, trying to weaken the arm so Joey Raiden cannot hit whatever move revolves around the use of his arm. And now Juice into the ropes. Oh, big whatever you call it, and it's good for a two count. I'm not sure what you call that move other than effective. And look at that, Raiden kicks Juice in the back and he just stands right back up. Now Raiden propped up against the ropes and oh, sends Juice flying all the way to the outside. And again, this match goes to the outside of the ring. And now look at Raiden, stomped on the knee. Stomped right down on that knee. And look at this, Raiden throwing Juice up the ramp, telling him, get out of here. Oh, man. Oh, come on. Camera guys, can you please try to get a different shot that is not directly behind that freaking support beam? And now, referee count at six, both men in the ring. And Joey Raiden going after the leg, just as I figured he would. And now, I called him Noah. Joey Raiden, sorry, with a, looked like a variation of the foot stomp, only with the knees instead of the feet. And that's good for a near fall. Very close to three, actually. And now again, driving the elbows into the forehead, right into that zebra printed headband. Saw Dance Party X last. I know Dance Party X has headbands like that. I mean, if you saw the poster of the current champions that we, of course, posted on our Twitter page a month or two back, and you know they have those very same headbands. Maybe there's some kind of affiliation there. We'll never know. Or maybe we will. I don't know. I guess it just all depends. As Raiden goes for a pin, but I believe that was only a one count. Ladies and gentlemen, I know I seem kind of off of my game, but that is just because of the fact that I am not going on good sleep right now. Like I said, long day working with the talent before the show. And getting things set up. You know, I got a big roll backstage before coming out here and talking to y'all for an hour or two. So, you know, it's a very stressful environment. But hey, I wouldn't have it any other way. And now Juice, back suplex on the apron, the hardest part of the ring. Man, that's gotta hurt. And I'll tell you, we know Joey's father retired from wrestling due to back problems. It'd be a crying shame if Joey ended up having similar problems because of that move, as Juice throws him head first into the turnbuckle post. And again! Oh! That's gonna leave a mark. His referee's count is up to seven, and Juice breaks the count. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, snapmare from Joy Raiden. And look at this. Grounding him again. Grounding the young man from somewhere. I'm not sure where Juice is from either. Oh, these elbow shots. But Raiden reverses. And now looks like this one's heading back into the ring as Juice with a big boot to the side of the head of Noah Raiden. And look at Juice just flaunting around. He knows he's got this under control. And Raiden very slow to get up here. And a big back suplex. I think that was a Saito or a Sambo suplex. Whatever it was effective. And a big stomp to the back of Joey Raiden. Now a club to the back. And now inverted suplex, taking Raiden down. Juice Mandela in complete control here. Lifts him up. Knee to the gut. Oh! I don't know what to call that, but that could do it. Two. Oh my god. Joey Raiden kicked out of that. I've never seen anyone do that before in my life. You know, I've been around for a while. Oh my god, a super kick! Out of complete nowhere, and that gets a two count. Joey Raiden clearly frustrated, not sure what to make of that. Not sure what to make of Juice kicking out of that. And now, ooh, big Death Valley driver. And now Juice backing up. Could we see this knee strike that he's become so famous for? Signaling for it. Oh, God! He nails it! But he can't capitalize. He falls to a knee after that. And that could cost him. Oh, he goes for the pin. One. Two. One. Oh my god! Joey Raiden kicked out of that knee strike. Man, I'll tell ya. It's probably the fact that Juice sat there for so long trying to catch his breath. Wait a minute! Oh. Raiden would be going for something. Wait a minute. I said earlier, I don't know what Noah Raiden... I said Noah Raiden again. Look at me go. I said I didn't know Joey Raiden's finisher earlier, but I forgot I have it in my notes. As, ooh! Juice Mandela with that Falcon Arrow off the top rope. Let me look for my notes here, see what Joey Raiden's finishing maneuver is. And looks like it is a roundhouse kick. Simple but effective. Same with Juice Mandela. I like it. Will we see it? Will we see the roundhouse kick from Joey Raiden? He might have been setting up for it earlier. But look at this. Juice putting Joey back up on top. Probably going to see that Falcon Arrow. Channeling his inner Brickwall Alex Silva here. Instead of the Superplex Symphony, it's the Falcon Arrow Symphony. It's a Symphony of Destruction. Now Juice. Don't look at this. Juice using the ropes for leverage. The ref doesn't see it, but Joey kicks out. And now Juice has Joey. Juice and Joey, Juice and Joey, Juice and Joey. Huh. Now he definitely is Juice and Joey right now. Look at this, Juice just like, is this the guy you wanted to see? I'll tell you what, Juice came out and he was a fan favorite. He had the people's attention. But he's kind of healing it up right now. Just being really arrogant. Ooh, that big time kick. Clearly we can tell Juice Mandela has much more experience than Joey Raiden with that huge fisherman buster. And could that do it? No. Two count only. Man, this match has been off the wall. These two are really showing their stuff. Now Joey... Oh wait, Juice! Juice and Joey, Juice and Joey. he definitely is juicing Joey. Again, I say it. And, ooh! Oh, look at Juice! He's getting fired up! Looks like he's... Juice is going up top! Elbow drop off the top! And now... hooking the leg! Two! No! Joey Raiden staying in it! Now... Oh, that move again! I'm gonna make up a name for that. I'm just gonna call it the Silver Bullet. I'm just gonna call it the Silver Bullet. And again, Joey Raiden kicks out of it! Man, that looks like a really impactful maneuver. And Joey Raiden continues to kick out of it. And another Sambo suplex. And Juice struggling to keep with it. Oh, wait a minute. Juice signaling for something. Do the facebreaker! Oh, man. Joey Raiden is busted open. He's busted wide open. He could be knocked out. That's gonna do it. What? How? How is Joey Raiden finding it in himself to kick out of these moves over and over again? Ooh! Big knee into the corner. Wait, Raiden pushes him off. Only to get caught in a snapmare. And now Juice has that arm again. Oh, Raiden. Raiden. Ooh, punch to the gut. Oh, another facebreaker. Will this do it? Two. No. He's kicked out of two consecutive facebreakers. How? How is Joey Raiden doing this? This man is bionic. It's like he's invincible. He's taking so much damage, but he keeps kicking out. The man is bleeding, and he's still kicking out. Juice is getting frustrated. He's not sure what to do here. I'm not sure what to do here. Oh, look at this. Jawbreaker. Doh! Big drop kick. And again, Joey Raiden is down. Going for the pinfall again. 2-0. Joey Raiden continues to kick out. I'll tell you what, this might be the most impressive showcase I have seen so far. And of course, this is only the second of four Rising Star showcases. But this has to be the most impressive showing I've seen so far. Nothing against Brad or Elijah on episode one, but these two are just killing it. Look at this Russian leg sweep from Joey Raiden. This is, oh, wait a minute. Joey signaling, could we see the kick? Are we gonna see it? There it is, the roundhouse kick. Joey Raiden nails it on Juice Mandela. Hooks the leg, one. Two? No! Joey freaking Raiden cannot put this one away. Juice Mandela cannot put this one away. Oh my god. Two consecutive roundhouses. And Juice is up. Oh, the hatch suplex. How? I'm amazed. Ladies and gentlemen, I've seen it all. From this, I've seen everything. I said I saw everything last week. I've seen everything tonight. Already. We're barely 30 minutes into this show. 30 minutes. Wait. 30 minutes? This match's been going that long? These two were not These two just will not die. These two will not give in. They want to be Rising Star Champion. I think this alone should just give both men an automatic pass. Whoever the anonymous GM is, I hope you're listening to this. And look at this, Juice Mandela, the Dragon Sleeper. Could he make Joey Raiden tap out? No, he lets it out. Realizing he's getting nowhere with a submission. Oh, elbows to the side of the jaw. Oh, big slap. And two. Snapmare takedown. And going back to the arm. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, big punch to the gut. Pulls him close to the center. Oh, in the leg with that. Oh, God, that move hurts me every time I see it. Now, oh, wait a minute, Juice getting fired up with the punch, with that punch. And then another one. He's getting his groove on. He's dancing. Oh, in the third. Juice Mandela getting fired up. Hooking the leg one more time. Could this do it? No. Nothing these men do to each other is enough to put it away. Two. Spinning. Soul kick. But oh, super kick again. Could this do it? Two super kicks. No. Oh my God. These two men are immortal. These two are just un... Oh! Big knee! Followed by a clothesline! Juice is getting frustrated. He's trying to think of a way he can put this match away. Oh, looks like he's going to call for the face breaker. Do, and he nails it! Falling into the cover. One. Two. It's got a... What? Oh my God! Joey Raiden! Kicked out again! Joey, you're making your papa proud! Look at this Michinoku driver! One! Two! No! Joey Raiden! I'm sure Noah's watching this. Joey, you gotta know you're making your father proud right now. And another Russian leg sweep. Look at the blood. The blood is all over his face. Wait a minute. Joey going up top. What are we going to see here? Go! Foot stomp. No. Reversed. I mean, Juice got out of the way. Oh, big kick. Oh, big elbow. We going for... Oh, wait a minute. German suplex. And now Juice willing his way back up top. Are we going to see a foot stomp from Juice perhaps? And it connects. Lifting him up. Throws him into the corner. Man, I'm going to lose my voice from this match alone. How am I going to get through the rest of the show? Wait a minute. Oh, inverted suplex up the top rope. Unprofessionalism at its finest, ladies and gentlemen. I just got a text message in the middle of this great match. You'll have to wait, man. I've got a match to call. I've got a job to do. So, if you don't mind. Oh, wait a minute. Juice missed the enziguri and runs into a Russian leg sweep again. Lifts him up, and now cranking the neck again. Oh my God. Going hooks the leg. One, two. Oh my God, that was so fast. Kicked out as soon as the referee slapped the mat the second time. Oh, wait a minute. Raiden getting flung to the outside. Oh, big elbow. Raiden comes back in. Another snapmare takedown from Joey Raiden, going back to the arm. I don't get what's with these two and working over the arm, but clearly it is not working. Oh, silver bullet! Silver bullet connects out of absolutely nowhere, and again, it doesn't get the job done. One more of these men have to do to each other. I'm convinced this match will never end. This match is going to go the whole length of the show. I'm convinced of this. Wait a minute. Juice backing up. Could be going for the knee. No, a third face breaker. This time getting a run start to it. Capitalize, kid. Come on. Now's your chance. He's knocked unconscious. Hooks the leg. One, two, and it's over. Oh, my God. Oh, what a match. Let's take a look at some replays. Here we see one of the many arm lock attempts from, this time was on Juice. Out of the ropes, into that impressive move, but man. Ladies and gentlemen, I gotta take a drink real quick. Ah, man. Woo. Ah. The crowd is exhausted, just like I am. Holy crap. There we see that silver bullet. I'm calling it a silver bullet. I don't care what Juice calls it. That is now the silver bullet. Because, I mean, it is effective. Just like a bullet. And then that face breaker, I'm not sure what he calls it. I'll have to catch up with him and see what he calls that. But it was enough to get the win. And your winner and advancing to the Rising Star Championship Tournament, Mr. Juice Mandela. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm getting told we need to take a quick commercial break. Stay with us. We'll be right back. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to OWA Fallout Episode 2, and if y'all remember last week, Joey Saron was in a brutal hardcore match against Intercontinental Champion Blake Harnage, and Joey Saron suffered multiple injuries. Harnage suffered a few minor injuries, nothing that'll probably stay with him long term, but we're getting word from our OWA doctor, John Calloway. And you should be seeing on the screen now the medical report. I'm going to read it off here. On last episode of OWA Fallout, OWA competitor Joey Saron was in a match against current OWA Intercontinental Champion Blake Harnage. He suffered broken ribs and all of that. But of course, as expected, the most severe injury came when Blake Harnage wrapped a steel chair around Joey's throat and proceeded to stomp the chair using almost all of his force. And as you saw right there, Joey Saron has undergone severe surgery and is going to be out of action indefinitely. That sucks. That honestly sucks. But we got to move on. The show must go on. I'm pretty sure Joey Saron will want it that way. And we got Freddie Orion coming out here. This is a new guy on the scene coming up in the independents of Southern California. He's told me that he aspires to be a film director, producer, something like that. He's not told me what type of film he aspires to do, but whatever it is, I mean, clearly he does not look like the type who would be seen in front of the camera, more or less maybe behind it. Honestly, I'm not gonna lie, ladies and gentlemen, if this man was in front of the camera in a movie, he would be that shady drug dealer sidekick who'd probably get killed in the first 5 minutes of the drug deal. But nonetheless, Freddie Orion out here to compete for us. This ought to be a decent showcase of a brand new talent. I can't wait to see what he's got in store for us. Oh, no. What a bad night to make your debut. Say it ain't so, I'm too late in saying that, it is so. Our Intercontinental Champion, Blake Harnage. Oh my god. This man from London, England, gave the beating of a lifetime to Joey Serrano in episode 1. I mean, it was bone-chilling. The things that Blake Harnage did to Joey. I mean, it was brutal. So intense. And I think the fact that Joey Serrano fought back just made Blake even more aggravated. Made him more angry. And more violence ensued, of course. I think the final nail in the coffin for Joey Serrano was probably his biggest moment of offense, which was that big pile driver through my announce table out here. And I think that just made Harnage even more mad. Let's see. Oh my god, look at his eyes. So intense is this man, Blake Harnage. I've never seen a man so bloodthirsty. I've never seen a man so intense. I haven't seen someone so intense since Gavin Octave, a man we haven't seen since Bloodsport. But Blake Harnage has definitely taken Gavin's place in a whole new way for intensity and sheer power. And here we go. Look at this. Harnage just screaming, telling Freddy to bring it on. Oh, he's coming at him. Oh no, he caught him. Oh, knee to the face. What's he doing here? Joe throws him into the corner. Now, whipping him into the opposite corner. Oh god, the cutthroat. Oh god! Big boot into the corner. Oh my god. Now he's going to follow up with that big sidewinder suplex. Oh, God. You could get the three count already, Harnage. You just pin him right now and get the three count. That's all it will take. Oh, no, but he's not done. Oh, no. Oh, no. We didn't see this on episode 1. But this move, he calls it Fall of the Kingdom. Oh, man. Oh, no. Now he's backing up. You know what this means. He's pounding on his chest. You know what this means? Lights out! For Mr. Freddy Orion. Do you even need to count? Referee, do you honestly even need to count? It's obvious. As soon as someone gets hit with that kick, it's over. No, there's no point in taking a commercial break right here. That match was maybe all the what, 5 minutes? So we're just gonna move on to our next match. How does that sound? Move on to our next match. And we're gonna have two more new talents. Coming out here right now is a man that I am very confused about. Dre Walters. This man. Dre Walters comes out here. He's got this very smug, arrogant appearance to him. But I've seen him backstage. This is a very smart, very intelligent man. I mean, the knowledge that this man rattles off about modern history, ancient history, white history, black history, Asian history. You name it, he probably knows an answer to it. Not to mention, he's probably one of the most skilled technical wrestlers we have right now. And his opponent is probably one of the best in Japan. Ladies and gentlemen, Roku Sarutobi. This man comes out,
and he gets a nice reaction from the crowd. I mean, the crowd clearly knows at least somewhat who Roku Sarutobi is, and you know, that's good enough. That's good to see. I mean, Roku is a very, very skilled competitor, very skilled technician in the ring, and just downright brutal sometimes. And this ought to be not so one-sided, unlike the last match. By far. Now, I hate to just up and cut in during the entrance, but I need to remind you guys, again, earlier in the night, Donny Octave and Brickwall Alex Silva, things got a little bit heated, and we saw a first glimpse of our anonymous OWA general manager, and he made our main event tonight, Brickwall Alex Silva versus a mystery opponent. And the winner of this match gets the title match, gets the Alpha Championship match at Adrenaline against Donny Octave in the main event. So that ought to be a good one. But right now, the bell's about to ring, so we need to divert our attention to this match. Roku Sarutobi and Dre Walters. And now Walters has him in a side headlock. Whipping him down. And now Roku wrapping the legs around the neck of Dre Walters. And Walters kipping out of it and getting back into the side headlock. And now Roku with a headlock of his own. And now Dre whip, tossing him into the ropes. Ducking under. Oh, and a big shoulder block from Roku, who immediately capitalizes, whipping him back into the ropes. And a big back body drop from Roku Sarutobi. And now getting him up for a huge inverted DDT. Call it what you want, I call it effective. And look at this. Ooh! Big move, I'm not sure what you call that. But it worked. And now Dre with that hip toss. Picking up in a sidewalk slam. And of course Dre Walters' finishing maneuver is that very reminiscent to the kill switch, or unpretty, or whatever you want to call it. But that's sort of what his finisher is. So of course his key target points are the head and neck. And as you see right there, Roku Sarutobi suffered a minor leg injury back in Japan before coming overseas to compete for us here in OWA. So you gotta know Dre might try to single that leg out if given the opportunity. But Roku, you know, the man has, Roku has more than one type of move that he can put his opponent away with. I mean, kicks, strikes, submissions, even. He can put his opponent away with literally anything. I've seen him do it. He doesn't have to use a single move. He doesn't have to use one specific move in every match. He can put his opponent away with just about anything if he wanted to. So it's hard to determine what Roku will use to put his opponent away in Dre Walters, but we saw him hit that kitchen sink to Walters, and Walters went flying upwards, like went straight up into the air. Now, Roku throwing Dre to the outside. Now, ooh, Dre throwing Roku into the barricade, doing a big Samoan drop from Dre Walters. Now Dre with that cute punches and the chop, but oh, Roku reversed into a huge shot of his own. Now the referees count up to four. Oh, and here goes Roku working over the leg of Dre Walters. And now Roku sliding back into the ring. Referees up to six. Roku begging Dre to get back in the ring. And Dre running in a, ooh, big knee, kitchen sink. And a dropkick to the back of Roku. Now, working over the arm of Roku. Slamming it into the mat. Oh, snapmare takedown from Dre Walters. And now into the chin lock.
wrenching on it. Oh wait, Roku looks to be trying to get out of it. Elbow, and another, and he breaks out of it. Now Roku, got that hammerlock cinched back in tight. Look at him wrench on the arm. Looks like he's trying to pull it out of that socket. Oh, but Dre, gets caught with that kick. Dude, big Uranagi slam from Roku Sarutobi. Hooks the leg. Could they do it? One, two, no. Roku visibly shaken by that one. That might be one of Roku's put away moves. Oh, wait a minute. Roku throwing Dre to the outside. What are we going to see here? Wait a minute. Oh, Dre tried to do something, but Roku jumped out of the way, and now Roku back into the ring. Oh, catches Dre again in that headlock. Again, throws him into the ropes. Oh, Dre powers Roku over his head, and a hip toss back into the ring. Flips him over. Pulls him to the center of the ring. Oh, big drive by knee. And now, hoisting Roku up on his feet. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, we've seen this from Dre Walters. Going for that combination of teardrop suplexes. There's two. Will we see the third one? And there it is. The teardrop suplex combination. And that could do it, ladies and gentlemen. 2-0. Dre Walters getting a little ticked off now that couldn't put the match away. Wait a minute. Roku. Dude, big hammerlock lariat. Now, pulling into the center of the ring. Oh, wait a minute. Roku going for his... Oh, the dragon sleeper. Oh my god, look at the way, did you see the way Dre Walters was bent in half? That was so brutal. How did it not break his neck? Oh, and the Japanese driver. One, two, no. Dre Walters kicks out. And now Roku trying to think, what can he do to put it away? Oh, wait a minute. Oh, big punch. Now Dre throwing Roku to the outside. Hip toss back into the ring. Wait a minute. Dre could be signaling for that impactful finishing maneuver. Oh, here he goes. Oh! Planting him face first. Hooking the leg, 2, and it's over. Dre Walters picking up a massive victory here. Man, look at this dragon sleeper. Look at the way Dre Walters was bent. He was bent like a freaking accordion. How that did not break the man, I'll never know. And then that big Japan driver from Roku Sarutobi didn't quite get it, and then this. Oh, it hurts every time watching it. And that was enough to get the 1-2-3. And your winner, Dre Walters. But ladies and gentlemen, do not go away. Up next, we're going to hear from the Total Package, Brian Richards, and then we're going to see the Tag Team Champions in action. So stick around.
Yes, my name is Brian Richards. Yes, I am the Total Package. Yes, I am that damn good. But yet, for some reason, management decided not to book me tonight. No. I get to the arena tonight and they told me, Brian, you don't have a match on the card tonight because nobody wants to get in the ring with you. Yeah, you heard it right, folks. The OWA locker room is afraid of me. So, here we go. I'm laying out the challenge. Any of you cowards who wants to prove you're different from the rest, I'm issuing a challenge. The Brian Richards Invitational is now open. Come one, come all, get a taste of greatness. My name is Brian Richards. I am the total package, and I am that damn good.
Strong words from the total package, Brian Richards. Of course, frustrated he was not booked on the card tonight, but it is what it is. The Brian Richards Invitational open starting next week. We'll see if anyone responds. Well, we got tag team action coming up here. Coming down to the ring now, we have Derek Endicott III and Max Jericho. DE3, we saw him on the first ever edition of OWA Showcase. Put on a great match against Ronan. Of course, Ronan came out with the victory. We haven't seen Max Jericho, though, before. The biggest thing to tell about this guy is who he is influenced by. I mean, just look at the jacket, look at the gear, you can kind of tell. I mean, even his last name, Jericho. Y2J, Chris Jericho, you know what, no, forget it. You all probably know, but here come the tag team champions. Ladies and gentlemen, it is party time! Dance Party X! Gabriel Garcia on the left, Adam Chunky to the right. These two men, the original first tag team in OWA, they made their debut as a team together at OWA Bloodsport. And whoo, they lit it up. They lit the stage up. I mean, they opened the show at Bloodsport last October, and they dominated Joey Solon and the inspirational one, Kelvin Corbin, who we have not heard anything from. Kelvin Corbin, that is. We haven't had any interaction with him in many months. We don't know. We don't even know if he's still with us. As in, still with us contracted. But whatever the case is, we're going to have Dance Party X taking on the team of DE3 and Max Jericho. And look at DE3. The size of this man and the overall build. But Adam Chunky just powers him up with that body, that backdrop anyway. And look at this, the power of Adam. Definitely showing a lot more skill since the last time we seen him. Of course, whenever last time we saw Adam Chunky, he was just, I mean, OWA kickoff in September was his first ever match in COP. OWA Bloodsport was his second, and of course Gabriel Garcia has been in COP for many years. He has loads of experience. So Adam teamed up with Gabriel, hoping to probably learn a few things. And now we got Max Jericho in the ring now, and Adam immediately goes after him. The one thing I notice about this young man, Max Jericho, is this kid is small. I mean, look at him. He can look the top turnbuckle in the eye. But he still managed to be able to lift Adam Chunky up with that shin breaker. Adam is a big man, probably like 175, 400 pounds, perhaps? Max Jericho looks to be 219, maybe. So that's a near 1 to 200 pound difference right there. And Adam with that big back suplex, just totally cleaning house. He has definitely gotten so much better in the ring. Look at him. Oh, big back body drop. Looks like he was going to back up into the corner and go for something. Oh, Max Jericho gets out of the way. Look. Oh, look at Max Jericho. That hip toss and the flipping theatrics. I wonder how DU3 found this kid. I mean, I don't know what the relationship is here between these two, but, you know. They must have some sort of bond. Clearly, they're both arrogant and cocky. As Max Jericho, the Michinoku driver on Gabriel Garcia, who comes in. And now, with this butterfly stretch, making Garcia look at his partner, Adam Chunky, on the apron. And Max Jericho fighting Dance Party X in their own corner. That takes some guts. Oh, look at that. Garcia coming in now. Whipping Max into the ropes. Oh, Garcia hanging on. Oh, D3 getting the tag. And now, oh my god, look at the size difference. D3 has to be the most physically impressive man in this match. I mean, he's probably all 6'4", 6'5", maybe 245 pounds of muscle. I swear, you know, just before the match started, you know, we saw the total package, Brian Richards. Derek Endicott III has to be the total package in OWA right now. Because, you know, we've actually seen Derek wrestle. We haven't seen anything from Brian Richards, a new signee to OWA. But nonetheless, Brian Richards is not in this match. So I'm not going to talk about him. Oh, look at that. Gabriel whipping DE3 over the top rope, sending Max Jericho down. He narrowly avoided getting hurt there. Look at this. Gabriel, monkey flip into the crossbody. Hook it into the pin. One, two. Oh no. Max Jericho didn't bother coming in to help him out there. Probably figured, nah, he's got this. He can kick out of this. And now a tag into Adam Chunky. Now the two big men are back in this. And a big back suplex from Adam to Derek. Oh, wait a minute. Adam, are we going to see his new move? We're going to see his brand new finishing maneuver. He's been using the house shoes. Adam bomb, and it connects full force. Hooks the leg. One, two. Oh, Max Jericho barely got in there to break it up. And now Adam going to the legs of DE3 to take down the big man. You gotta go after his vertical base, go after the legs, and that's exactly what Adam Chunky did. Oh, speak of the devil. DE3 went after the leg of Adam Chunky and now a tag into Max Jericho. Derek does not look happy. I can tell you that much. And now Max whipping Adam to the apron. Oh, big punch right there. Wait a minute. Derek trying to get in the ring. And the referee tell him, no, you can't be in here. You're the legal man. As Adam with that big snake eyes. And now referee, one, two, no. Dude, big kick to the back of Max Jericho. Oh, wait a minute. Dude. Oh. Max. Big back suplex. Man, Max Jericho finding his niche here. Or not. Forget I said anything. I said nothing about Max Jericho finding his niche. Where's the Men in Black Neuralizer when you need it? Or maybe not. Look at this. Oh, lifting him up high in the Brainbuster. And now going over the leg of Adam Chunky. Picks him up. Whipping him back. Oh, and a tiger suplex. Dropping him on the back of his head that's almost 400 pounds. On the back of Adam's neck. That has got to be uncomfortable. Now Max Jericho in full I'm not even going to finish that sentence. Adam Chunky with that jawbreaker to Max Jericho, and now a tag back in to Mr. Party Town, or Funky Town, whatever it was. I believe it was Mr. Funky Town. And now Max, Russian leg sweep to Gabriel Garcia. I was going to make a tag to Derek. What? What the hell? Derek jumped down saying, no, you got this. You can do this on your own. Wait a minute. The Mexi Driver. Mexi Driver to Max Jericho, and Derek Endicott III is just watching. Look at him nonchalantly get in the ring, not even bothering to help. Max has to kick out on his own, and he barely did that anyway. And now Adam looking to throw Derek out. Or not. Adam jumps out of the ring. Derek trying to collect himself. Gabriel. Dude! Big fist drop type move. Max looked like he hurt his arm on that one. Now pulling Max away from the corner of his team. If you can call it that. Now working over the leg of the little man. It's weird to call someone, well, actually Max Jericho is taller than Gabriel Garcia. But not anymore, he just knocked him out with those punches. That's just called slobber knocker. Oh, look at this! And that was enough to get the job done. Dance Party X win the match. After that miscommunication between DE3 and Max Jericho, I doubt we've seen the last of that. We'll probably get a follow-up on that later on. But because of that miscommunication, Dance Party X pretty much had the rest of the match. Here we see in this replay the Adam Bomb. Adam Chunky's new finishing maneuver that he's been using on the house shows. Sometimes Gabriel Garcia himself will follow up with a senton. And there we see that Mexi Driver to Max Jericho. DE3 just standing on the ground watching, pulling himself back on the apron. And look at how slowly he tries to get back into the ring. And then these rapid fire punches with the dancing theatrics that split. And pulling him away for the three count, as we'll see right here. One, two, three. As Adam holds him in a head, holds DE3 in a headlock to keep him away. And Dance Party X are your winners. And ladies and gentlemen, up next is our main event. Brickwall Alex Silva versus a mystery opponent. We gotta take one last commercial break. We'll be right back. Stay with us.
I had a dream. Vast landscape. Where everybody came together in unity. crazy part is that it's real.
Welcome back to OWA Fallout, and it is main event time! Here comes, without a doubt, the most popular man in the OWA right now, Brickwall Alex Silva. This man, our first and by far probably longest reigning OWA champion to date, 5 months. 6 months, actually. 6 months as Alpha Champion. Our most popular Alpha Champion, and probably our best. Our most reliable champion. Not like Donny Octave. I'll be honest, Donny Octave has gotten on my nerves big time ever since OWA first started back. He came back in and, you know, just started with this crap of the same old overlook story that's been played to death, and then he came in and pulled those tactics to win the Alpha Championship. It was utterly ridiculous. And now Silva, instead of getting his rematch like he should, he was screwed out of the championship. He has to jump through these hoops set up by the GM to do this, and I'll be honest, I'm kind of curious, who is the mystery opponent? Hear the music. Oh my god, it's Leo Legend! Leo Legend, we haven't seen this guy in months! I can't believe it! Leo Legend is back! He's back in the OWA! This is unbelievable! Last time we heard from Leo Legend, he had resigned from his contract. He was let go by the OWA. We thought we would never see the man again. But here he is! He's back! And he's competing in a number one contenders match for the Alpha Championship. Wow! What a shock! What a shock here, ladies and gentlemen. Leo Legend is a guy that for most people were saying he could be a main eventer, and here he is, he's in the main event of episode 2 of Fallout. But the crowd doesn't sound too happy. I mean, they are booing the man. Probably because of who he's facing. Nonetheless, Leo Legend and Alex Silva. This should be a match for the ages, ladies and gentlemen. Here we go, both men getting warmed up. And here we go. Both men locking up in the center of the ring. Silva with a side headlock. And Legend into the ropes, whipping Silva. Ducking under. Oh, shoulder block from Silva. Picks him up. Throws Legend to the outside. Or no, Legend catches himself. Big shot to the face of Alex Silva. And now Legend, oh! Throws Silva all the way to the outside. the strength of Leo Legend. But Silva kicking the knee out of Leo. And now the rapid fire punches. Oh! Wow! The disrespect! The slaps! The disrespect of Leo Legend. He's paying for it right now, getting thrown around. Man, I'll tell you what, Leo Legend is a phenomenal wrestler. No one's taking that away from him. But the amount of disrespect this man shows is unbelievable. And now the match goes back inside the ring. Silva, knee to the back of the head of Leo Legend. And now Silva throwing Legend onto the rope. Whipping him. Ooh, big rolling elbow. Turning him over. And a camel clutch. Oh, but Legend immediately lifting him up and throwing him back down. And Legend catches him. Snapmare. And now the elbows into the skull. Into that recently stitched up wound. And now working over the arm of Alex Silva. Working over that arm so he can't hit that Night Terror jumping cutter move. Oh, wait a minute. Silva hoists Legend up. Oh, Silva with the signature trash talk, and it turns around to bite him. And now Legend has him in a front face lock. Ooh, big knee to the nose. And now Legend snap suplex on Alex Silva. This match has been very even so far. Silva getting up. These two men are just total powerhouses. And now Legend with a cravat neck breaker taking down Alex Silva. And now Legend with the hammer and chin lock. Look at... You can't see it from your angle, ladies and gentlemen, but the way Silva's arm was bent in between Legend's leg. And now, oh, Silva will be going for a hangman's neck breaker, but Legend got out of it, whips Silva into the corner. Oh, hoisting up to the top. He's going up. Go back suplex. That looked to have an effect on both men. Legend looks like he might have got hurt a little bit on that one. Turn him around. And a German suplex. Dropping him on the back of his head. You could get a concussion from that if you're not careful. And now Legend working over the head. Probably to set up for his trademarked Superman punch. And now Silva has him up. And a big flapjack. Oh, and big kick to the chest. Legend rolling out of the way of that stomp. Silva into the ropes. Missed the kitchen sink. Oh, big back suplex. And now hooking the leg. One, two, no. Only a two count. What a night it has been so far, ladies and gentlemen. We're about to crown a number one contender right here for all of you. I hope you're ready. I'm ready. And Donny Octave, I hope you're watching this closely, because you'll be facing one of these two men in adrenaline. Neither one's going to be an easy task for you. Leo Legend with a Russian leg sweep, dropping Silva in the center of the ring. Whipping him over, going back to that hammer and chin lock. Look at the way his arm's bent. Look at the way his arm's folded on Leo's leg. That has got to damage the arm profusely. Oh, wait a minute. Silva throwing Legend into the corner. Hoisting him up. What are we going to see here? Wait a minute. Go! Back suplex of his own up the top rope. And Legend just folded. Two? No. Only a two count. Now Silva. Oh, forearms into the head of Leo. And a fist drop right into the forehead. Oh, and a small package. Could this do it? 2-0. Legend gets out of the small package. Oh, Legend pops up. Oh, oh! That move, wait a minute, Legend backs up. Cocking the fist. Superman punch, signature Leo Legend maneuver. Pulling Silva away from the ropes. Could this do it? 2? No. Kicks out at 2. Oh, big slap. Oh, putting him there. And a big knee across the chest. Oh, wait a minute, Leo. Are we going to see the fall of Legend? We're going to see him put him up on his shoulders. Oh, my God. Fall of Legend. We have a new number one contender. And it is Leo Legend. If he can get the 3 count. 2. No. Oh, my God, ladies and gentlemen. Nobody that I know of has ever kicked out of the Fall of Legend. Ever. Unbelievable. And now Silva immediately just capitalizing right back. Oh, but Legend quickly, dude, with the elbows breaking out of that shin lock. Now. Oh, butterfly. Oh, wait a minute. Dude, into the cross arm breaker. Could he make Silva tap out? It'd make him tap out or he'll break his arm. Wait a minute. Oh! Nice punch. Oh, wait a minute. Silva. Oh, that's where the taunting's going to get you. Silva's been in the business for a while, but he still doesn't know when to quit the taunting. And now Legend working over that arm. Working over both arms of Alex Silva so he can't hit that Night Terror finishing move. Tell you what, if Legend can damage those arms good enough, he could have this one in the bag. Wait a minute. Legend off the ropes. Ooh, big elbow. Spinning back elbow. Signature Alex Silva maneuver. Oh. Big forearm shot in the belly-to-belly suplex. He falls to a knee, though. He's getting tired. The former champion is getting tired. What are we gonna see here? Alex Silva. Oh, big knee. And another big knee. Follows up with the Russian leg sweep. Hooking the leg. Will this do it? 1, 2, no. He kicks out. Legend struggling to get up, but he finally does manage to get up. Go half suplex into the corner. Goes down for the pin. 1, 2, no. Legend is getting frustrated. Legend not sure what it's going to take to put Alex Silva away. Oh, look at that, just kicking him down. Picks him up. Go! Back body drop. Picks him up. Oh, Silva going over the top rope. Catches him up on the apron. Oh, wait a minute. Silva sunset flip. Into the pin. 1, 2. No! Not enough. Doing that big backbreaker or neck breaker, whatever you want to call it. Into the corner. Are we going to see a... Oh, no, not a superplex. Just ramming the shoulder into the gut. of Leo Legend, and now stomping away. A Legend pushes him off. Alex Silva throwing Legend into another corner. Whipping him back in, off the ropes, and a face buster. Now Silva wondering what he's going to have to do. You need to capitalize what you need to do, Silva. Oh, Legend rolls out of the way. Oh, gets caught though. Chop. Oh, wait a minute. He's putting him up. The crowd's starting to cheer. They know what's coming. A signature move of Alex Silva. He's going up to the top with Leo. Superplex. And the symphony begins. Come on, Alex. You need... Oh, wait a minute. Maybe the symphony's over. He's calling for the Night Terror. Night Terror. That's going to do it. One, two, three. It's over. And Alex Silva earns his rematch for the Alpha Championship. What a match that was. Leo Legend making his insane return to the OWA. And what a match that was. I'll say it again. What a match that was. A great showcase for both men. Alex Silva putting it all on the line and coming out on top. Of course, Leo Legend hit both his patented Superman punch and the Fall of Legend. But neither one could put the match away. And then that small package almost got it done. And you can see the referee's count here. We got a two count on that. And then, oh, right here. The sunset flip through the ropes. That seriously almost could have done it there. See how close it was. The referee's hand was coming down, and then this big emphatic Night Terror cutter got the job done for Brickwall Alex Silva, and he will be going to OWA Adrenaline to get his shot at the Alpha Championship. What a match that was. What a show this was. Another great edition of OWA Fallout. And Alex Silva, wait a minute. Donny Octave, oh my God, no. No! Turn around, Alex. Oh God, Donny Octave with the steel chair to the back. What the hell is this? Donny Octave coming out from the crowd with a steel chair and he's assaulting Alex Silva with the chair. What the hell? What is the meaning of this, Donny? Come on! No. Welcome to Octavia! Reopening the wound! Oh my God, Donny Octave, you son of a bitch! You son of a bitch! Oh God. What's he doing? He's calling for something. Wait a minute, what's he doing here? Oh my God! What was that? Holy... Donny Octave, you son of a bitch. Ruining another moment in OWA. Ruining yet another moment. Ruining another night. That's all the time we have for this episode, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you enjoyed. My name is Braylon Summers, signing out. See you on next week on episode 3.